My mother was a pilot in World War II, and she really blazed the trail for women in the military. So, because she spoke so highly of her military service, it inspired me to join the Air Force, and I was very, very fortunate to have in my career the opportunity to step into many roles traditionally occupied by men. I'm Bonnie Carroll, the president and founder of TAPS, the Tragedy Assistance Program for Survivors. I'm an Army surviving spouse. My husband, Brigadier General Tom Carroll, was killed in an Army National Guard plane crash with seven other soldiers on board. When my husband was killed in an Army plane crash, I went searching for the kind of support I knew existed for other types of loss in our society. This is America, and we have a support group for everything. But back in the early 90s, I was absolutely devastated to find that there wasn't one for military families grieving the loss of their fallen hero. So I went searching for resources. I struggled to find the kind of support I knew had to exist, the emotional connection to others grieving a military loss. It wasn't until I reconnected with these seven other widows who had lost their husbands in the same crash as mine that we found that we had everything in common. We truly had a sisterhood. We could support each other. We could share some very intimate thoughts without judgment. We could be a support to each other around the clock in those dark hours. And it was from that epiphany that TAPS was really created as a national program for all those grieving the death of a military loved one. I ultimately served over 30 years in the National Guard and the Reserves, retiring in 2012 as a major. I've had the opportunity, serving in the National Guard, to be part of teams of women. In fact, back in the Alaska Air National Guard, one-third of our membership was female. So when we did an entire operational readiness inspection with all female leadership and came out with an outstanding, what was really rewarding is no one noticed it until the very end at the party. So it's been an incredible journey. I never found throughout my career really any discrimination between male or female. It was all about how we take care of each other, how we're there for each other, and how we absolutely are able to meet the mission at hand. It was a tremendous honor to receive the Presidential Medal of Freedom. You know, I really accepted that on behalf of all surviving families. This certainly wasn't a solo effort. What TAPS has created is a family, a national community, and now a global community of all those grieving the loss of a military loved one. We come together to help each other heal, and the recognition that I received was done on behalf of all of us who have suffered a loss in defense of freedom.